Welcome to the final Barrington Sports Monday Night Hockey of the season. I'm Simon Mason, and in the Women's Premier Division, we look to the battle for the playoffs as Clifton Robinsons head to Surbiton and Leicester travel to Holcombe. In the Men's Premier, Canterbury entertain Brooklands Manchester University in a bid to avoid the relegation playoffs, and at the top of the table, Surbiton host Wimbledon. First to Sugden Road, as Clifton Robinsons were the visitors to the home of the league winners. Knowing that to stand any chance of getting into the playoffs, they would have to win and hope results elsewhere went their way. Here's the highlights with Charlie Brougham.
Penalty corner to Surbiton. Goes to Giselle Anslick. Anslick fires it in, and good save by Sarah Ellis. Ball still alive though for Surbiton. And the shot comes in from Page, and it's well saved by Ellis. Here's the first one. Good right glove. Kept alive by Emily Atkinson. Back to Sarah Page, and Page on target, but Ellis equal to it. And corner for Clifton goes to Thomas. Thomas gets it goal bound. It's a goal mouth scramble, and it's in the back of the net. Clifton through Joey Lee have an 11th minute lead, and they've converted their first penalty corner. Let's have another look. It's Claire Thomas that gets it goal bound. What happens? Well, it gets behind Louisa Bray, and Joey Lee squirms it over the line. Despite the best efforts of Giselle Anslick, the number five, who just sees it squirm over the line and onto the backboard. Sideline ball will be taken by Palmer. Palmer plays it forward. Well, it's gone all the way through, and a chance here for Croson. Croson with the finish under Louisa Bray. And on the stroke of half time, Clifton have doubled their lead. Surbiton nil, Clifton 2. Well, it's Route 1 stuff, but it's very effective. And Megan Croson with a great finish underneath Bray to double the lead. Plenty of work for Surbiton to do in this second half. And here goes Joe Hunter. Hunter driving to the line. Davis in hot pursuit. Pulls it back to Hunter. And the ball is there. Shot comes in from Page. And, well, it's a standoff between Hunter and Palmer. Who's going to blink first? Everyone waits to see. And it's Palmer. Good work by the number six. Here's the drive from Hunter. Pulls it back. And just for a moment there, Ellis looking for the ball. And then she's on the floor with a hot seat view. Up the line from Atkinson. And it's gone all the way through. Now, Julia King with an opportunity. King one-on-one with the keeper. Tries to go around Ellis. Good save by Ellis. A follow-up shot comes in from Page, and it's cleared off the line. Clifton coming under all sorts of pressure in this second half, but managing to keep that goal intact for the moment. Good save by Ellis. And she needs the secondary line of defence to save it a second time. Penalty corner goes to Ansley. And Ansley flings it into the back of the net. And 8 minutes into the second half, Surbiton are on the score sheet. Giselle Anslick, the scorer. Let's have another look. Oh, well, Ellis completely unsighted by Izzy Palmer. Drive down the right-hand side for Clifton. And there's the lead from Danson, but can't get hold of the ball. She gets it now. Deflection saved by Bray, and the follow-up also saved by the Surbiton keeper. Danger looked to have been averted here, but the first time ball across, Danson, two bites to Cherry, can't find her way past Bray. Down the corner goes to Ansley, and Ansley sees a very good drag flick, well saved by Sarah Ellis, away to her right-hand side. This time the keeper, with no one in front of her, makes a fine save. Penalty corner goes to Ansley. No, it doesn't. There's a switch to Page, who then fires it in, and Becky Middleton deflects it up and over Sarah Ellis, and it's 2-2. Move from the top of the circle. Well worked. Ellis, little she can do about that one. Penalty corner goes to Ansley, and Ansley changes side, and Ellis is equal to it with the glove. Still not out of harm's way. Shot comes in from Haycroft. And it up off Ellis. Dangerous play. Will be another penalty corner. There's the first save. And there's the second shot comes in just there. penalty corner given away for that. Ansley, and this time she finds a way through on the keeper's left-hand side. And with 8 minutes remaining, Surbiton are in front for the very first time in the match. Surbiton 3, Clifton 2. Between keeper and post player, Ellis was going the other way. Penalty corner to Clifton. And it comes, and the deflection in front of the keeper is up and in. Aileen Davis, with 4 minutes to go, levels things up. From behind the goal, they were looking for the deflection, and for the second time, Ansley desperately trying to get the ball out of the goal. There to be a winner. Ball played back to Twig, who plays it into the circle, and it's deflected in by Becky Middleton. Her second of the game, and 2 minutes from time. Surely that has given all 3 points to Surbiton. It's the softest of goals for Clifton to concede. They played so well all afternoon, but they might get nothing for their troubles. Down that left-hand side, is there to be? No, there isn't. That is the final whistle. What a game we have witnessed here, but Surbiton continue their winning run. Final score, Surbiton 4, Clifton Robinson 3. And for the visitors, I'm afraid, no playoffs this season.
Leicester travel to Holcombe in the same knowledge as Clifton, with 3 points a must and keeping their fingers crossed that other results went their way.
There's a sideline ball for Holcombe. It will be taken by Erin Hunter. Hunter plays it towards the circle and they're in round the back here. Holcombe, shot comes in from Bobs and it's a comfortable save from Jeffries as ball is played back. Bobs steps away from a marker, sweeps it, but gets underneath it and it's a comfortable bat away for Jeffries. Penalty corner. White miscontrols, so they run a variation here. Here's Maguire, plays it goal bound, and everyone's missed it, and it's gone in. Emily Maguire, 9 minutes in, gives the home side the lead, but Leicester will be bitterly disappointed as it went through a sea of legs at a rather innocuous pace. Maguire just shovels it goal, looking for the deflection, but everyone misses it. Penalty corner. Running another variation here, and it's slapped goal bound by Elliot looking for the deflection. And Leicester get it clear. Number 16, Elliot, peels away to the left hand side, fires it in, looking for the deflection from Wilkinson. Leicester survive. Oh, that's a miscontrol by White, and they could be in trouble here as Leicester get the equaliser. Katie Long levels it up, but it's Holly Payne who provided the pass. But Holcombe, well, it's a disastrous ball out the back. White under all sorts of pressure, can't control it. Payne has a little look up, sees Long, plays it first time, and Long scores. Here is Wilkinson to Maguire. Just about gets away from Payne and plays a lovely looking ball here to Hunter. Hunter into the circle, shoots, good save from Jeffries, and another save from Jeffries. It's still not away, and Leicester somehow survive. Whistle has gone. Well, there's at least two saves in here from Jeffries. There's the first with the pad. It avoids Woods. There's the second. She scrambles back, and then as the third shot comes in, does that hit the defender, Briscoe? Here come Holcombe again to the line. Played back by Hunter. Cut out by Newland. Still got possession here. Here is Woods. Woods plays it back out to the 23. Fired in. Here's a chance. And that is a good save by Jeffries from Ellie Watton. As the ball is played in here, Watton gets the touch. And it's off the face mask of Jeffries. Hunter with a free hit. Woods fires it in. Here comes Jeffries again, another couple of saves and it's still alive. Jeffries goes down and there's another one off the helmet from Caitlin Jeffries. A double save in here, scoops the ball clear and another one off the helmet, still one all. Aerial ball thrown and Woods is on her bike and Woods gets possession. She's in round the back here now. Can Lucy Woods find the ball across? Woods. Jeffries makes the save and then it's batted away by Briscoe. And Leicester survive yet another Holcombe onslaught. And can they counter-attack down that right-hand side? They can't, and there is the final whistle. A draw is not good enough for Leicester, but it could have been worse, was it not for the antics of Caitlin Jeffries in the Leicester goal. Holcombe 1, Leicester 1, the final score.
Reading's final match in the Premier Division ended with their first victory of the season, thanks to a 19th minute goal from Emma Thomas. East Grinstead got the victory they needed away at Bowden Hightown, thanks to goals from Blackwood, Brennan and two from Locke. The University of Birmingham took the lead away at Canterbury thanks to Amy Costello. Eliza Brett levelled things up early in the second half before Holly Hunt sealed the win for the visitors in the 44th minute. So, Surbiton will face the University of Birmingham and Holcombe will take on East Grinstead in the playoffs, with Leicester and the University of Birmingham narrowly missing out. At the bottom, we say goodbye to Reading, whilst Bowden Hightown head to the relegation playoffs, with Slough and Canterbury retaining their Premier Division status for another year. In the men's Premier Division, we head first to Polo Farm Sports Club for the relegation playoff decider between Canterbury and Brooklands Manchester University. Canterbury went into the game 3 points behind the visitors, but with a superior goal difference, so a win would keep them safe. But for Brooklands, a draw or a win would confirm their place in the Premier Division for another year and consign Canterbury to the relegation playoffs.
Down this left-hand side for Brooklands, and the ball cut on its way by Peter Flanagan. The free hit is given. There's an opportunity for a crossing, and it's deflected wide of the mark by Sam Perrin. Ball came across to John Crossley, and the shot by Perrin gets too much of it. Down the corner and from Ross Hall. There's a straight drag flick, and it's into the back of the net. Peter Flanagan gives Brooklands the lead on the 22nd minute. Canterbury 0, Brooklands 1. A straight flick, and Stubbings well gets half a stick to it. The pressure coming from Canterbury, and it's being turned over by Hayward. Hayward trying to show a clean pair of heels to Dan Vincent into the circle. It comes, shot comes in from Oates, and a very physical tackle on Oates. But nothing given. Peter Flanagan with the challenge. Penalty corner. Again, it's a straight strike. Oh, that's a really good save, because that takes the deflection off the number one runner. It's another penalty corner. But from behind the goal, you'll see it takes a big deflection off Burton Bowen. Ball again to the top of the circle, and the flick is comfortably saved by a flying Dick and Stubbings. That one a little higher. Stubbings equal to it. Canterbury at least two goals in this second half, and keep a clean sheet as well. They've got to win this one. The ball is fired in now. Here's a chance. A half chance perhaps, and that's all he needs. Craig Boyne beats Chris Scott in the Brooklands goal. And with 28 minutes remaining, Canterbury are level and they have a lifeline. Boyne's got an awful lot to do, but he shrugged off the challenge of Little and put Scott on his backside. So Canterbury got themselves back on level terms. Can they push on and find this second goal, take the lead, put some pressure on their opponents? Brooklands through Clark, good meet free hit. Clark will take it. Clark, there's a ball picked up by David Flanagan. Flanagan into the circle, and Canterbury can try and get it clear. Well, it's not clear, it's back into the danger zone, and they've got to be careful here, and it's in the back of the net! Well, David Flanagan makes it Canterbury 1, Brooklands 2, and Canterbury haven't been on level terms for a minute. Really disappointing from a Canterbury perspective. They switched off at the restart, and Brooklands have taken full advantage. Credit to them, and it's a really smart finish from David Flanagan up into the roof of the net. Here come Brooklands again. Canterbury desperate need of some goals as the ball is played into the circle. Oh no, from a Canterbury perspective, that is a real nail in the coffin. Ross Hall makes it Canterbury 1, Brooklands 3. It's a really smart goal, because he uses the pace of the ball as it comes in here, gets in front of his marker and deflects it into the back of the net. So Canterbury have got to throw the kitchen sink at Brooklands now. Clark comes away, but Boyd tackles back and Boyd with the ball over the top and a chance here perhaps for Canterbury. Right across the face of goal. No one anticipating at the back post. A real opportunity to get one back. Let's have another look. Will Hayward on the far post, but he doesn't anticipate. Well, Brooklands under no pressure here, not chasing the game. So they play it up around the back. Oh, it's been miscontrolled by Nick Little. Little under a bit of pressure from Craig Boyd. And Boyd has possession. Boyd, can he get the shot away? Oh, you bet he can! What a goal from Craig Boyd! And with 8 minutes remaining, Canterbury need two unanswered goals. What a finish from Craig Boyd. Nick Little just takes his eye off the ball. And even then, he can just play it off the side of the pitch, but decides to keep it alive. Boyd wins possession back. And, well, he has no other option but to take it on himself. And what a finish that is. In it comes again from Canterbury. And Brooklands are trying to get it clear, but they can't. Here's the chance on the reverse stick from Hayward. It's been ruled out for back sticks, much to the dismay of the Canterbury players. A clear indication from the umpire that it came off the back of the sticks. Penalty corner. The last play of the game. And it's saved by Scott. It's out of the circle. And it is a win for Brooklands. They maintain their Premier Division status. For Canterbury, it is the playoffs for the third successive season. Can they make it a hat-trick of wins in the playoffs to maintain their Premier Division status? Final score, Canterbury 2, Brooklands 3.
Next to Surbiton. They hosted league leaders Wimbledon in front of a good Mother's Day crowd. Looking ahead to the playoffs, neither side would be keen to lose to their potential final opponents. Let's join Charlie Brougham for the best of the action.
On the back, and Surbiton, bit of pressure from the Wimbledon forward line, but now they drop off. The ball down the middle is a poor one. It gets a touch and they've turned possession over. Here have Wimbledon, they could be in. Here is McIntyre. McIntyre on the reverse, and there is Phil Ball to make it 1-0. Well, Surbiton, what a disastrous passage of play. At the back, you can see Harry Gibson with his hands aloft asking what is going on. McIntyre gets the initial touch, picked up by Gred, played to Ebbers, who finds McIntyre. McIntyre on the verse and Phil Ball turning it past Gibson. Surbiton around the back once more, not deterred by the first goal. Well, they've just seen another pass intercepted and they could be in trouble again here. It's spun in by Miller and here's a chance. And can they finish it off? Yes, they can. Johnny Kinder makes it 2-0 and Surbiton have gifted away yet another goal. Surbiton 0, Wimbledon 2, 21 minutes in and the champions are in control of this one. Again, a pass from the back is picked out by a Wimbledon player. Miller spins it into the path of Kinder, who beats Gibson. And it's Surbiton 0, Wimbledon 2. McIntyre will play it back to Orr. Here is Evers. Evers down that right-hand side. Picked up by Tom Woods. Woods goes past Males. Woods into the circle. And the shot from Chris Gregg. Let's have another look. It's wide, but how wide was it? As Woods battles against Males, gets the ball across. It's not far away. Surbiton down that right-hand side, patiently looking for the openings to appear. And they might appear here. And here is Proza in round the back. Pulls it back, shot comes in, and it's just wide by Luke Noblett. Good intricate play down the Surbiton right-hand side. It broke kindly for them. Proza played in round the back, Little look up, sees Noblet. He can't hit the target. Good effort. Been here before for Surbiton, and twice they've conceded goals. This time, however, they get it out and down the right-hand side. The outlet is Beckett. Beckett back into the circle. And here's a chance. Good save by Bailey. It's still not clear. And in the end, Weir does get it clear. Beckett, little look up. Lovely little ball. And it's a really good chance. And it's a really good save from Bailey. And Henry Weir on hand just to get it away. Penalty corner for Wimbledon. And it's flicked goalwards by Lorenz. And Borja Lorenz makes it Surbiton 0, Wimbledon 3. 7 minutes into the second half, and Wimbledon in complete control of this match now, between keeper and postman for the third. Down this left-hand side is Hildreth. Hildreth wants the free hit, gets it. Forsyth takes the free hit. Here goes Alan Forsyth. Forsyth into the circle. Could be an opportunity here. The ball comes across. Forsyth can't get it, but it drops to Drayton Chana. And Surbiton are back in it. Arjun Drayton Chana makes it Surbiton 1, Wimbledon 3. 5 minutes after they conceded a third, Surbiton have a lifeline in this game. Forsyth with the drive, and as it's played back across the face of goal by Males, Forsyth can't make it, but Drayton Chana can. Penalty corner. It's going to be Furlong with it, and Furlong makes it 2-3. Two goals in 8 minutes, and Surbiton right back in it. Gareth Furlong for the penalty corner. Does it get a deflection? Well, it doesn't matter from a Surbiton perspective because it's in the back of the net. Surbiton looking for the equaliser. Creed into the corner of the circle. Back it comes. Little spin. Shot comes in. Patted away by Bailey. And, well, Wimbledon can't get it clear. Back in it comes. Shot comes in. And this time Bailey gets a solid left-hand kicker to it, and a chance for a counter-attack here for Wimbledon. Ball over the top, and here is Phil Ball, and Phil Ball on the reverse stick. Can't find the target. Well, here's the second save from Bailey at one end, and at the other end, here's the opportunity for balls that probably make the game safe. Penalty corner. This time it's Noblet on the top circle, and it's off the line from Mantell. It's still there. Noblet has his hands in the air. It falls back to Noblet, who puts it in the back of the net. And Surbiton have completed an unlikely comeback against the league leaders and champions. 3-0 down to 3-3 in the penultimate minute of the match. Noblet with the first shot. Mantell off the line. Mantell there again to try and get it clear, but Noblet sticks it into the space where Mantell was. Now, is there to be a last chance for either side? Wimbledon on the front foot. Here is Kinder. Kinder, can he get in round the back? Yes, he can. Kinder still going, pulls it back and gets cleared. Mo only as far as Mantell, who can't touch it cleanly with his first touch. Can't get it out from underneath his feet. And Surbiton will get it clear. And there is the final whistle. Well, what a game of hockey. We have witnessed Wimbledon racing into a 3-0 lead. But three goals in the last 22 minutes. See Surbiton gain a hard-earned point.
The other playoff sides, Hampstead and Westminster and Holcombe, played out an entertaining 3-3 draw, with six different players getting on the score sheet. Reading won away at relegated Loughborough Students by 6-1. James Carson and Ben Boone both scoring twice. Beeston finished their season on a high as they beat East Grinstead, thanks to goals from Richard Lawrence and Joe Sharp. Wimbledon will take on Hampstead and Westminster in the playoff semi-final, with Holcombe playing Surbiton in the other. Beeston, East Grinstead and Reading all finished the season in safety, joined at the last minute by Brooklands. Canterbury will head to the relegation playoffs, with Loughborough Students being relegated after one season in the top flight. That's all we have time for tonight, but we'll have lots more content coming out over the coming weeks, so make sure you subscribe now and head over to galvanisedhockey.com.